Namaste, my dear students of Gurukul Nilokhedi and Gurukul Jyoti sir. Hope that you are fit and fine at your home along with your family members. So, this is second part of class 8th, chapter number 11. Class 8th. Chapter number 11, pressure, that is pressure. In first part, I have discussed what is pressure and what are the factors on which pressure depends, what is the formula of pressure, what is the SI unit of pressure. And we have done also two numericals on the basis of pressure. As we know that formula of pressure is given by pressure equal to force per unit area. Force per unit area. So as you can see from this formula, pressure equal to force upon area. So if force is increasing, pressure is increasing. Force is decreasing, pressure will be decreased. So as you can see, pressure is also depends on the another factor, that is area. Pressure depends on basically two factors, force and area. Force and area. In case of area, pressure you can see equal to force upon area, that is area is in the denominator. If area of surface area of the body is increases, pressure will decrease. Or if area of the body is decreases, pressure will increase. So it is, we can say, pressure and area are inverse of each other. As we have discussed some examples on the topic, that is pressure. So similarly, we can calculate numerically. I am taking another example. Suppose this is numerical. Suppose calculate the pressure on an object when a force of 20 newton is acting on an area, five meter square. From this formula, we can calculate pressure. In this question, pressure. What is given? Force 20 newton, area 5 meter square. What is given? Force, that is F equal to 20 newton, area 5 meter square. Pressure, we can write P equal to F upon A, force upon area. Force is 20, area 5. That will be 4 Pascal. What is the SI unit of pressure? It is Pascal. And 1 Pascal we can write from this formula, Newton upon meter square. equal to Newton per meter square. In short form, Pascal can be written as Pa equal to Newton N upon meter square means N square. So 1 Pascal equal to Newton per meter square. 1 Pascal equal to Newton per meter square. Similarly, if area is given in second question, suppose we force acting on an object we are considering 10 Newton, 10 Newton, and if area in this question, area of the object is given 2 centimeter square, then we have to convert area, that is it is given in centimeter square, we have to convert centimeter square into meter square. Then we can write, as you know, 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter, 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter, and 1 meter square equal to 100 into 100 centimeter square. That will be 10,000 centimeter square. Or we can write 1 meter square upon 10,000 equal to 1 centimeter square. So from this formula, from this conversion, we can convert centimeter square into meter square. Centimeter square into meter square, that is 1 centimeter square equal to 1 upon 10,000 meter square. 1 upon 10,000 meter square. So we can write 2 upon 10,000 meter square. 2 centimeter square equal to 2 by 10,000 meter square. Then pressure, calculate pressure. Pressure will be force upon area. What is force? 10. Area 2 by 10,000. That 10,000 will go in the numerator. That is 10,000. It will be 50,000 Pascal. 50,000 Pascal. So pressure in this case, when force is given 10 Newton, area 2 centimeter square, then pressure equal to 50,000 Pascal, or 1 Pascal, 1 Pascal equal to Newton per meter square. We can write 50,000 Newton per meter square. 50,000 Newton per meter square. So these are the variables by which we can calculate pressure, if force is given and area is given. By using simple formula, pressure equal to force upon area. Force upon area. Now, next topic is, till now we have discussed the pressure exerted on solids. Similarly, we can explain pressure exerted by liquid and gases. Means, liquid and gases can also exert pressure. Liquid and gases can also exert pressure. Now we will see. Next topic is pressure exerted by There are many examples. Suppose in the case of gases, suppose we have a balloon. We have a balloon. And if we are blowing air, air is blown into the one part of the balloon, then gas will go inward, and that gas exert pressure. That gas exert pressure inside the walls of the balloon. That gas exert pressure inside the walls of the balloon so that it will expand due to increase in the pressure inside the balloon. Balloon will expand if we continuously increases that air. Then at a situation due to high pressure, that balloon can burst. So it means the air that is blown at the one end of the balloon, it will exert pressure on the walls of the balloon, and which causes the expansion or due to which balloon will expand. If we are continuously increasing the air inside the balloon, it will create high pressure. Due to this high pressure, balloon can burst. It means it is a simple example. And gases exert pressure inside the balloon or walls of the balloon. Similarly, if in the case of liquid, this is the case of gases. Similarly, in the case of liquid can also exert pressure on the balloon. Suppose this is a tub containing some liquid, or we can say water is here, and there is a balloon. And if we are pressing that balloon, it means we are applying force. We are applying some force on the first end or upper end of the balloon. That balloon will go down inside the liquid, that is because of applying force. So after some time, suppose it is submerged into the Salmo. Bano.
And this
having a cubical shape. Having a cubical shape. Then at a particular depth, this is liquid surface. This is liquid. Pressure exerted by the liquid is equal at each point on an object at the same depth. It means the pressure applied by this liquid on this object is equal at each point. Suppose this is the force, this is the pressure applied to this end. This end also. This end. So pressure at each point will be same in this case. We can take one example also. On the basis of activity, we can prove how liquid pressure is same at each point on the same depth. On the same depth. Again, we have to take this liquid beaker containing liquid. Suppose at initially you have to take this beaker. This is plastic. You can take plastic glass. This is the shape of the plastic glass. Suppose it is cylindrical. If you are with the help of iron nail, you are putting a hole that side. You can make another hole on the same depth here, 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 on the back side also. That should be same. That of hole should be same. Now using the cellophane, cover that hole. After that, take a water and fill inside it. We have to take a water and fill inside it. Now you can see after some time you have to remove this cellotape. What will happen? Liquid will come out. Liquid will come out and it will cover a same distance. It will cover a same distance from the beaker. Because liquid exert equal pressure at each point, same pressure at each point inside the glass. So the distance covered by this energy coming out liquid will be same from that beaker in all the direction. This is the front part, this is front part, liquid is flowing out. The distance covered by the liquid, although you can say speed of energy, liquid will be same. Speed of energy liquid will be same on everywhere, on each point. Here, liquid will come out with the same speed because at each point inside the plastic glass, the depth of each hole is same everywhere. So liquid will come out with the same speed and it cover the same distance and around this plastic glass. So this is the activity by which we can prove liquid at the pressure exerted by the liquid is equal at each point for an object at the same temperature. Next property, liquid pressure increases with depth. How liquid pressure increases with depth? It is very clear. Suppose you have a beaker containing some liquid, you have a plastic bowl, it will float on the surface, then liquid will exert some pressure on the plastic bowl. You can say this is object. The pressure at this point, this is surface of liquid. The pressure will be very, very less. Liquid pressure will be very, very less in this case as comparison to if we are placing this object here. If we are placing this object at this point inside the liquid, now object is submerged completely. So you can see if this is the object inside the liquid is exerting pressure on this object due to its depth. Here object is placing on the surface. Here you can see object is placing on the surface. There is only air pressure. There is no liquid above this object. So there is no liquid pressure, you can see. But this is first situation. Second situation, this object, if I place this object at this second point, the liquid exert greater pressure on the second position because depth of the liquid is increasing. So at the bottom, this is the bottom of beaker, or you can say bottom surface, at this position liquid, the depth of the liquid is increases. So at third position, maximum pressure exerted by the object at this point, maximum pressure exerted by the liquid at this position or at this point because of its depth. There are many examples you can take. If there is a swimmer, if a swimmer is swimming at the surface of the liquid, less pressure will be exerted because there is only air pressure is there. But if swimmer is going down inside the liquid, liquid exert pressure on the swimmer at the very depth of the you can say pond or sea, or you can say if there is a pond and swimmer is diving at very depth in the liquid, at the very high depth inside the liquid, he feels very much greater pressure on him. So that's why swimmer use diving suits. It is a specially designed suit that used by the swimmer inside the liquid at greater depth, due to by which they feel less pressure because of liquid. So they can swim easily at depth also. So this is the properties of liquid pressure. We have taken one example. You can take another example. Think you have to think over it. These So this is all about of today's lecture. We have done up to now what is pressure, formula, numericals, and what are the factors on which pressure depends, and what are the properties of liquid pressure and pressure exerted by liquid and gases. Thank you.